right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to talk Wonder Woman, but we're talking in terms of the Oscars. Once again, some more Oscar talk. So, Entertainment Weekly, if you go to Entertainment Weekly site, sometime around July the 6th, I see here, they put out 23 contenders for the Oscars. Now, they're not all in the same categories, but nonetheless, you can have, so far they have 23 films for the year, which are contenders for the Oscars, and we'll go through that in a minute. But first of all, I'm just going to highlight some of those that you might have heard talk about, because they did pretty well at the box office as well. So you have Dunkirk, right? Of course you have Wonder Woman. You have Dunkirk, which is a Christopher Nolan-directed film about some events that happened in the Second World War. We have War for the Planet of the Apes, directed by Matt Reeves. We have Spider-Man Homecoming, that's actually, you know, it's been mentioned. We have Baby Driver. We have The Big Sick. We have Beauty and the Beast. We have Okja. I don't know if any of you have heard of Okja, but it's a Netflix film. Logan. Alien Covenant, believe it or not. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. Get Out. And The Beyond. Okay? Now, what's interesting is that Entertainment Weekly, they give the reasons why they think these are contenders, and they also talk about what categories they think that they can actually enter to try and get nominated. So they start off first and foremost with Wonder Woman, directed by Patty Jenkins, and they nominated for the Best Picture. They would nominate for the Best Picture, Best Director, Patty Jenkins, Best Production Design, Best Visual Effects, Best Costuming, Best Sound Editing, Best Sound Mixing. Okay? Get Out. This is directed by Jordan Peele. And they would direct. They would nominated for Best Picture, Best Original Screenplay, Best Director. Okay, you got The Big Sick, and they would nominated for Best Picture, Best Actor, which is this gentleman here, Kumail Nanjiani. You know it's a comedy, right? Best Supporting Actor, Ray Romano. Everybody loves Raymond. And Best Supporting Actress, Holly Hunter, who we see right here. Best Original Screenplay. That would be some of the nominations. Their nomination, The Beguiled. For Best Actress would be Nicole Kidman, Best Director Sofia Coppola, Best Adapted Screenplay, Best Costume Design. Call Me By Your Name, I don't know it, this is not one I'm very familiar with. Best Picture, Best Supporting Actor, Armie Hammer, and Best Adapted Screenplay. And then you have Mudbound, which would be another one that I haven't heard about. Best Actor, which is Jarrett Hedlund. Best Actress, Carrie Mulligan, and Best Supporting Actor, Jason Mitchell. Best Supporting Actress, Mary J. Blige, she's known for singing. R&B. The Florida Project, Best Picture, Best Original Screenplay, Best Supporting Actor, William Dafoe, who's known for Spider-Man and he's going to be in Justice League. Wonderstruck, Best Supporting Actress, Millicent Simmons, Best Production Design, Best Original Score, Best Cinematography. The Disaster Artist, which is a kind of comedy, it's a spoof on. Anyway, Best Actor, James Franco, Best Adapted Screenplay, Scott, and then Michael H. Weber. Logan. They would be nominating the Best Supporting Actor, who would be Patrick Stewart. You have The Killing of the Sacred Deer, which would be for their Best Original Screenplay. Wind River, same thing, Best Original Screenplay. Beatrice at Dinner, looking at the Best Actress, Salma Hayek, right? Okja, which is the one on Netflix. Best Cinematography, Best Original Screenplay, Best Visual Effects, and Best Supporting Actor, Jake Gyllenhaal. Then we have here, Good Time, Best Actor, Robert Pattinson, which would be this gentleman here, and Best Original Score. Beauty and the Beast, they would go all the technical stuff. Best Costume Design, Best Production Design, Best Visual Effects. The Lovers, the Best Actress, Deborah Winger, she would go out for Best Actress. Makes sense. Colossal, Best Actress, Anne Hathaway, so she would be vying for that too. Maudie, Best Actress, Sally Hawkins, and Best Supporting Actor, Ethan Hawke. I haven't seen Sally Hawkins in a while, I didn't know she was so busy acting. Alien Covenant, they're looking at Best Production Design, Best Makeup, and Hairstyling, Best Score. You got The Boss Baby, Best Animated Feature. Guardians of the Galaxy, all the technical stuff, Best Makeup and Hairstyling, Best Costume Design, Best Visual Effects. And War for the Planet of the Apes, directed by Matt Reeves. The Best Actor, Andy Serkis, which he really does deserve that, I would say. And Best Visual Effects. Okay? Now, quite frankly, if you're talking about vying for Best Picture, Wonder Woman, I don't see it winning it, but definitely, by all means, Warner Bros. Should be actually bringing out a campaign to see if it can get nominated, because it's really in the runnings with all those other movies. Now, in terms of Best Director, I think that Warner Bros. Has the best director in Patty Jenkins. I really do believe that, and I'll tell you why. If you look at all the other movies, the main protagonist is someone who has been in acting for a while and has is someone who's brought up in acting. Dunkirk doesn't really have a main protagonist per se, but it's centered around this young actor here, and he is an actor, okay? He's grown up in acting school, okay? When you look at War for the Planet of the Apes, Andy Serkis is known for mocap acting, okay? He's done it in all kinds of things, Lord of the Rings, you name it. Mocap, it's Andy Serkis, okay? He did an extraordinary job in terms of acting. When we look at Tom Holland in Spider-Man Homecoming, he's an actor. That's what he does. He's been in acting. That's what he does, okay? He didn't come from another area into acting, okay? Baby Driver. All of these people here. Ansel Elgort. Kevin Spacey, who's an Academy Award winner. Lily James. Ezra Gonzalez. John Hamm. And even Jamie Foxx. Jamie Foxx didn't begin as an actor. He began as a comedian, musician. But he's got his acting chops. Kind of like Will Smith. He's now like a seasoned actor. Okay? He's been in a number of hit movies, in movies which Academy Awards were nominated for them. So he's been there. So you have to consider him a seasoned actor. Okay? You look at The Big Sick. All of these people are seasoned actors. Okay? You may not have heard of them, but they're actors. They come from acting background. Right? Beauty and the Beast. Again, seasoned actors here. Okja. I don't know too much about Okja, so I can't say anything. It's about animation and it's someone I don't know too much about now. Logan. Come on. Hugh Jackman. Seasoned actor. Okay? Even the young girl playing is an actor. She that's what she does. She goes to acting school, etc. Alien Covenant. All seasoned actors there, right? Main protagonist, seasoned actor. Guardians of the Galaxy, even though it's a comedy, Chris Pratt is a seasoned actor, okay? Zoe Saldana is a seasoned actor. Okay, Dave Bautista is not a seasoned actor, but he's not a main protagonist in the story, right? He's a supporting cast. Vin Diesel, supporting cast. Bradley Cooper is a seasoned actor. Kurt Russell, seasoned actor, right? Get Out. Get Out. Again, seasoned actors are here, alright? And I'm just emphasizing my point, the big guy. I mean, the person who they're nominating here, Kirsten Dunst, she's a seasoned actor, okay? This is Kirsten Dunst right here, okay? We got also Nicole Kidman, who's a seasoned actor. That's why we're talking about best actress, right? That's why she's going for that, right? Everybody in here is seasoned actors, okay? The only film where you do not have a seasoned actor, you have somebody learning on the job, the only thing she's really major thing she's been in has been Fast and the Furious, and she was a supporting cast there. It's Gal Gadot. So it says volumes about Patty Jenkins directing when she can take a non-seasoned actress. Gal Gadot, she's been in the business for about 8 years, I think. Just a good time, but she's not a seasoned actress, okay? And she's not grown up in the arts. She's not grown up acting. She was going to be a lawyer, right? She was a model, but she was going to be a lawyer. Patty Jenkins took Gal Gadot and built this movie around her into a very successful movie and brought out of Gal Gadot the acting chops that makes everyone around us say Gal is Wonder Woman. And brought dimension to Wonder Woman and brought up things from Wonder Woman we've never seen any female actor do. You know what I'm saying? It's unique. The movie is unique. That alone sets Patty Jenkins apart from every single director that we've just proposed. Then, Patty Jenkins takes a comic book movie and highlights relevant things to this time. Things that are practical. Things that we can do. She breaks it down so that little kids could understand and adults. Because it's a eureka moment for both adults and children in this movie. It's a game changer. It's not just that she's a female director and the first female director to get this kind of budget and get this kind of blockbuster success with a superhero-directed movie that's a woman. No, that's all incidental. You look at the story of Wonder Woman, and the story of Wonder Woman is probably more comprehensive. You know, Patty Jenkins does this in such a subtle way. She takes these complex things, and she makes them all look simple. You know, she brings it down to the lowest common denominator, and she brings emotion to these things to make them real. Patty was dealing with a number of issues. She was dealing with racism. She was dealing with sexism. She was dealing with nationalism versus humanism. She's dealing with issues such as the fear of parent-child loss, the fear of loss of your child, okay? She was dealing with leadership. You see the contrasting leaderships. Diana knows a certain kind of leader. We see Ludendorff as a kind of leader. We see the Allied Forces have a certain kind of leader, all right? She deals with broad themes such as the dark and the light sides of human beings. It's an idealistic movie. It's inspirational. She also deals with the evils of war. And she deals with all of these things with different sceneries and different tones. You understand what I'm saying? She's going from way back in the past to the present time. You understand what I'm saying? She's also dealing with different worlds. And she's able to bring all of these things into a coherent story, which has the same kind of punch and Zack Snyder themes as any Zack Snyder story. But she's able to pull off the most offensive things, if you think about it, and the most hurtful things by putting on its basis inspiration, the musical score, evoking certain emotions from it. This is not a popcorn flick, in my opinion. This is a deep, firmly rooted movie that's grounded. It has a certain degree of fantasy to it, but at the end of the day, this is a highly rooted movie, and this movie would not be made this way were it not for Patty Jenkins. She's done a special piece of art in history that's having, will have tremendous consequences to it, because the younger children, the next generation, is going to adopt and embrace these ideas and principles. And this will ensure a better future for us all. A much more equal, fair world. And in the environment and the atmosphere, the political atmosphere we're in, this movie is much needed. So, and she also even touches on environmental issues, which is really crazy. But I just believe that Patty Jenkins is a skilled director who is able to bring out certain things from a movie that would otherwise not be felt. And it's a skill in weaving that with characters, with a lead protagonist who is not a highly seasoned actor with accolades. And able to bring this forth, surrounding this actor with some very skilled and seasoned actors, she's able to produce this kind of movie. And there's a resounding response, not only financially, but also by people, her fellow colleagues in the business. You hear these people speaking about this movie. All right, let you understand what I'm talking about. So if I can just back up a bit. Now, Hollywood is actually going to have the Academy Awards open to more voters and a much more diverse set of voters, okay? But this is still very interesting to see this. I want to show you here. Let me back it up. And listen to what is said here about Wonder Woman by a prospective voter in the Academy Awards. The Oscar voter, Terry Crews, he tells E! It sent goosebumps down my spine. I got choked up in the theater because I felt like this is possible now. Whereas before, it actually was not possible. Wonder Woman broke a paradigm. And women all over the United States of America, they cried. I cried too, so. But they cried for different reasons than I cry, right? But nonetheless, this movie has changed the way, not just in movies, but it changes the way how people visualize and view other people. This movie is a movie about embracing others, not about pushing them away. It's not about my cubicle. It's not about my nationalistic values. It's not about me winning and being better than you. This movie is an embracing movie. It's very powerful. And you very rarely find movies like this in Hollywood, which are brutally true. They don't compromise. Because Patty Jenkins did not compromise anything in how she depicted Wonder Woman. And was respectful to not only the lore of Wonder Woman, but respectful to woman, period, in this movie. And I thought, you can't do it better than that. And so I'm just going to say right now, Patty Jenkins already got Charlize Theron an Academy Award. I'm not saying she gets Gal Gadot an Academy Award, but I think she deserves one. She deserves it. Best director, not best female director, not best male director, best director. And Wonder Woman's making that statement at the box office. But, you know, we can ignore the box office for a minute. She's making a statement to the world. To the world. There are certain countries that ban Wonder Woman because they know the power of that movie. They're using other guys, oh, gals and Israelis. No, no, no. You want to continue your chauvinistic behavior in your country. And, you know, women would rise up when they see this movie. And this is a powerful, this is a very empowering movie. Very inspirational, very powerful. I'm not saying it's only for women. I'm saying anyone. Like Wonder Woman says, I will fight for those who cannot speak for themselves. That's what this movie's about. And it's powerful, y'all. It's powerful. Anyway, you leave in the comment section below what you think. Do you think that at least Patty Jenkins, as a director for Wonder Woman, should be nominated, and hopefully she should win Best Director for 2017? I truly believe there's no one else that has done it better. No one else. I've watched it, Logan. It was a nicely directed, it was a very good film, but it doesn't have that kind of impact that Wonder Woman has. And so if you're talking about best director, it has to be Patty Jenkins. Has to be. Hands down. She's not using established actor to be the main protagonist. You gotta factor in how many issues she was able to allow this movie to touch people with. This was no ordinary movie. This movie was saying things. You know, you were entertained, but it was saying things. And then the skill she had to take offensive things in this movie, to take atrocious things in this movie, and to put it in such a way that the inspiration is enough to carry you out of those things. Because some atrocious things happen in this movie, but people are able to digest those things. And even little children, which is amazing. This is a PG-13 movie. This very well could have been a rated R movie. I'm telling you right now. Just because Patty Jenkins directed the movie a certain way, this movie is not that. This movie reminds me of Gladiator. Gladiator was more about revenge, though. This movie's not about revenge, okay? And I just love every aspect of this movie because you see women. It's like Gal Gadot fights as a woman. And the other thing that's really interesting is she does not fight with hate or malice. She's trying to get the job done, but she's not fighting with hate or malice in her heart, which is pretty cool. On that note, you guys have a great one. This is a special movie, though. Leave your comments in the comment section below, and don't forget to donate.